You know, outrigger canoe paddling is a pretty unique opportunity because it's one of the few post-collegiate team sports that anybody can get involved with without a whole lot of talent. There's something for everybody. If you're just a recreational Joe lunch bucket kind of guy off the street and you want to go out and be teamy and clubby and really enjoy the social part of a sport, there's that element in outrigger paddling. If you want to get semi-competitive, you can do that because of the other commitments that we all have with real life stuff. And if you want to get super competitive and really travel the circuit internationally, then that's out there as well, and there's some rewards for that. And people kind of dabble in all of them. It's funny. It's once you get the fever, the passion, you never leave. I don't know what's the matter with us. You just never leave the sport. So it's really a lifestyle.
Well, I woke up this morning, a rainbow filled the sky.
You take your typical nuclear family, you know, that sort of unconditional love. People can make mistakes and you forgive them. They can be away for a long time, and when they come back, you sit down and you start to talk story, and it's like they never left. It's this mutual respect. It's forgiving them any of their faults because you appreciate and celebrate their strengths and the beauty in them. And you multiply that by 100 or 1,000 times, and that's sort of our ohana. It's all of our circle of paddling friends, relations, people that they know that may not even paddle, that are involved in any sort of land, ocean, environmental, artistic, musical endeavors that touch on the cultural aspects, I guess, of the Hawaiian spirit, of the Hawaiian spirit of aloha.
Ohana, well, as you know, ohana is family. And like I share with you, our canoe club, we try to be ohana. We like to win, but we want to be a big family together. And in a crew, I guess in a crew, it takes 6 people to win a race. So if you can think as a like family.
Is a blue shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend, take you out of this place, someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful.
Shoot.
tuna fleets clearing the sea out. See the bedwind fires at night. See the oil fields at first light.